actually started in Acts chapter 2. And this was when the Holy Spirit came upon the earth. That was when the church started. I mean the universal church. That is when it started, Acts chapter 2. The church did not start before Acts chapter 2. Praise the Lord. And since then till now, the impact of that revival is still alive. The Holy Ghost has not left the earth. The Holy Ghost is still in the earth. Praise the Lord. So you cannot separate the church from the Spirit of God. You cannot separate the church. Anywhere you see people gather and say they are doing church and the Holy Ghost is not there, it's not a church. Praise the Lord. Anywhere you see what people gather and they say it's church and the Holy Spirit must be there. He's always there. Bible says, where two or three are gathered, if you gather in the name of Jesus, the Holy Spirit is there. Praise the Lord. But wherever you see any place they call church and they say we don't believe in the Holy Ghost this time, my friend, run away. Praise the Lord. It's not a church. Acts chapter 19 from verse 32, if you read down, and the Bible says an apostle Paul met certain people. He said he met them. He didn't say he met part of the church. He said he met them. He met them. They were together. And he asked them, have you received the Holy Ghost since ye were baptized? And they told him, they said, we know nothing about the Holy Spirit. We don't even know who they call the Holy Spirit. He said, we don't know who they call the Holy Spirit. He said, we only know baptism, water baptism. Water baptism. Praise the Lord. The same water baptism that John the Baptist said, he that cometh after me. He said, I baptize you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. Praise the Lord. They said, we don't know anything about the Holy Spirit. We only believe in water baptism. Paul told them something. And he said unto them, unto what were what? He baptized. And they said, unto what? In other words, Paul was trying to say, as far you are baptized into Jesus, the Holy Ghost, you're supposed to know the person of the Holy Spirit. Because why? In this last day, the Holy Spirit is the one in charge. Praise the Lord. The Holy Spirit is the one in charge. That is why Apostle Paul asked them, unto whom were you baptized? Praise the Lord. Unto whom were you baptized? What am I trying to tell you? I'm trying to tell you that these last days, the importance of the Spirit of God. Most things, it's not about you coming and just falling. Praise the Lord. They say, we don't know. They may have received it before, but they say, we don't know anything they call the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. They say, we don't know. You have to have an understanding. I want to show you one revelation. Who believe in Trinity? In case you don't know, we believe in Trinity. Praise the Lord. Trinity. There are three persons of the Father. That's why you are getting it. God manifests in three dimensions. He manifests the Father, the Son, and what? And the three are one. Now, wait. Jesus always tells his disciples, my Father that sent me, he that sent me, he that sent me, he that sent me. In John chapter 14, verse 8, the Bible says, and a man called Philip, one of his disciples, just met Jesus and said, Master, you always tell us about the Father, that the Father is greater than you, that the Father is better than you, that the Father sent you, that the Father is speaking through you. They show us the Father. If you show us the Father, by this we are satisfied. He says, show us the Father. And the Bible makes us to understand that Jesus said unto Philip, he said, have I been with you for a long time? He said, and you still don't know me. I believe at that time, maybe the disciples of Jesus will be confused. How can you tell us to, you say, show us the Father? You always talk that your Father is greater than you, your Father is this, and now you are telling us, have I been with you? It was a misery. The misery of Trinity. That's why you cannot argue Trinity with somebody that has not received the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. It's a waste of time. Trinity is a misery. Trinity is a misery. It is strong meat. Once you see somebody arguing about it, just avoid the person. There are some mysteries you don't argue with an ordinary believer. He will never understand it. It's a mystery. Jesus said, I am in the Father and the Father is in me. He said, that is the mystery. We are one. Praise the Lord. I want to also tell you, the person of the Holy Spirit.